Hi everyone, today I will be showing you basically how to set up a torpedo solution totally manually. We'll be using a Type 7C in the 7th Flotilla 1941, just because we don't have to worry about radar then and too much air cover. I just wanted to make things almost as simple as possible, but not as simple as 1939, just because that's not quite as exciting. I'm gonna set our hydrophones to KDB here just so we have a better search radius, but other than that I'm not really gonna touch this. I'm assuming stock 7C, whatever torpedoes they give us, so I'm just gonna go with that. I'm not gonna monkey around with the crew at all, and yeah, I guess we'll just jump right into it. So yeah, I'm not gonna be using map contact updates. That might be a little daunting to some, but I'm going to show you that you really don't need that. Maybe to learn the initial like spotting ranges of your watch officer and sonar man, stuff like that, it's useful, but maybe not the best for viewing experience. But I just wanted to demonstrate that you can fairly easily do all this on 100% realism. It kind of makes the game feel like work, but it can be a lot more rewarding too. So, should be February 1st that we hop into this, and I will update you when we are underway. Alright, so here we are at our patrol grid, BE-97. Just gonna slow us down a bit. So, I think we're in the middle of a convoy route. We're a little bit east of what they're showing the convoy route to be, but we'll spend a few days here and then maybe move a little further west. I'm just going to be creeping along at like 40, 60 meters, somewhere in that area, and just kind of waiting and listening. I was getting some contact info, radio contact info about a convoy heading south, but I didn't really want to chase that, and I wanted it to be like on an authentic spotting of a ship instead of going off radio intel. So we're just gonna patrol around here, and as soon as we come across something interesting, I will see you then. Okay, first contact we've had. It's been quite a few days since we covered our first grid. I've been moving us a little further west. B-97's way over there. We've moved quite a bit west, so we've got a warship contact moving fast, relative bearing 75 degrees. I'm just at 58 meters depth here. Oh, there's a second contact. So 75 and 72, we will... First thing we're going to do is take a listen on the hydrophones. So I'm going to hit H, and I'm going to turn up the volume here a little bit. So that's maxed out if I click there. Let's see what we've got in our hands. Well, it sounds like more than just destroyers, but okay, basically how it works is if you've played with map contact updates on for a while, you'll know that basically your sonar men can pick up sound contacts roughly about 20 kilometers away, give or take. This is my first patrol, so just basing it off that knowledge, I'm gonna make some assumptions here. So we can hear that they are at, let's just get an idea here, say the highest concentration's right around 75 there, and they say moving fast. So I'm gonna draw a line about 20 kilometers away in that direction. So I've got the tool helper on here, the top right, that question mark. Gonna grab this ruler, and we're gonna go 75. So right from our sub, 75, that gives us almost directly north. So 359 on the inverted compass. We'll just extend that line out about 20 kilometers. Maybe a little shy of 20, something like that. Well, we'll call it 20, but whatever. So I'm just going to make an X there. That's where we're guessing they're at. If they're moving fast, there's not a very good chance that we're even going to be able to hit anything here, but we'll get to periscope depth and see if we can at least make visual contact. So it's a lot easier to judge course and speed when you know roughly how fast they're going. So when they're going slow or medium speed, fast could be a little tougher, and we can't really estimate their speed by listening just because of how many there are. If there was one ship, you could kind of estimate just on the rate of like the RPMs or whatever that the screws turning that you listen for. But that sounds fast. I mean, it's probably anywhere between 14 and 21 knots. So I'm just going to estimate. I'm going to take a ballpark number and say, let's say fast speed is like 16 knots, okay? So if they're going 16 knots and I give them 10 minutes on this chart, that's about 5 kilometers. So from when we picked up that contact, 1505 and 15, we'll go from 1505. We'll draw a 5 kilometer circle here with our compass tool. And I'm gonna put us into silent running. Pick up speed till we get to periscope depth. And then we'll do a hydrophone check after it's been 10 minutes. So at 15:15, we'll check again. And yeah, I'll see you in about 6 minutes. Okay, so it's now 15:15. I'm just gonna ask my sonarman here where they're at now. So nearest warship contact, he's gonna say is 6-8. Okay. So we were at 7-5 before. I'm gonna draw a line at 6-8. So about 3:52. Extend that line to our circle. And this is not gonna be accurate at all, but this gives us somewhere to start. So if they were there, there's two things basically that can be going on. They could be at this intercept of the circle or this one out here, but we know they're closing. So if they were at that estimated point and they're now basically anywhere on the edge of this circle because they can travel 5 kilometers in 10 minutes, we're guessing. We're going to make a line of where this intercepts our circle. So again, that's our initial guess of where they were. This circle is where they could be after 10 minutes. And now we know they're in that direction relative to us. So that intersection is going to be their course. So looks like just shy of 210 degrees. So I'm going to extend that line at about 209. So this should be their course. I mean, it's going to be nowhere near exact, but that's going to give us a starting point. Now, what I want to do is turn us on a 90-degree angle of what I think their course is. So if I take this protractor, make a line to their course, make the end of the line where they're going, and then drag this so that it's 90 degrees. That's saying we have to face at 299 degrees to make a 90-degree angle on bow. So I'm going to turn us to 299. So we're going to make a slight left turn here. And let me just speed us up until we get straightened out. Okay. Now, let's see where they are. See if we can make visual contact. 47 degrees. Okay, let's put up the periscope here. Oh, it looks like it's a clear but rough day. Okay. Not seeing anything yet. Let me take a listen. Maybe more toward 40, honestly. Yeah, I don't see anything. I'm gonna pick up the pace a little bit. And we'll give it another 10 minutes. Alright, I've slowed us down again. And basically, we're gonna be able to make visual contact within like, I'd say 10 kilometers or less. So if this is their course, right now we're pretty darn far from where they're going to be. We're just about 8 kilometers away from like the closest point at which they'll pass by. So if I take a listen here, oh, they're now right in front of us. About 15. Yeah, so I think we're gonna miss these guys. They're going way too fast for us and they're way too far out. If I extend this at 15, they're probably about 8.5 or further away, depending on how accurate our reading was here. So let's just look at 15 degrees because that's where we hear them. Kind of wonder what it is. It sounds like more than just destroyers. Oh, there's something. Yeah, they're definitely going to be way too far out to attack. Not that we'd really want to attack them anyway. If there was a capital ship in there, maybe, but I'm not really in the habit of hunting down destroyers. Oh, actually, there's something huge out there. That might just be a cruiser. I don't think that's a battleship, but I do see pretty tall superstructure and another tall mast. Yeah. Probably their true course is something a little bit more like this, I would say, and they're going pretty darn fast, so we're not going to be able to catch these guys, but we will use a similar method in the future when we come across some merchants, hopefully. I wish I could see what that was, though. That's it's just like a white outline on my screen right now, right there. There's one cheesy thing you can do if you're not totally all about looking at targets in rough seas like this. You can just pause the game and it'll clear up anything. So, I mean, I can see the outline pretty clear now. Obviously, you don't want to do that if you're playing the game for real. That's kind of like defeats the whole purpose of playing with full realism. But you can see there's her outline right there, and she is way too far off to engage. All right, so we just got contact. Something at 271, moving slow. Okay, it sounds like it could be going about 7 knots. Slow is typically like 5 to 7 knots, medium 8 to maybe 12. But that sounds like a little on the faster end of slow, so I'm gonna guess 7 knots. Draw a line from 271 here. Gives us, 257 on the inverted compass, so 257. I'm gonna extend that about 20 kilometers or so. Make an X, that's where we think he is. Or she, or whatever. We're gonna give it 7 knots, let's see. We'll give it about 20 minutes, so there's nothing on here for 20, but 10 minutes times 2 at 7 knots, that gives us about 4.3 kilometers. So, again, just the speed and then how long you want to wait, and then we'll draw a circle with the compass to kind of figure out roughly what their course is. There's a lot of other ways you can track course, but this is just what I do. Tends to work fairly well. So 4.3. So anywhere on the edge of that circle is where he should be 20 minutes after we picked him up. So at about 10 after 4 p.m., we'll take another listen. I will update you then. Welcome back. I'm just bringing us up to periscope depth, and we're going to get an update from our sonarmen on where this guy is. I've also changed our course a bit. Okay, so 322 relative bearing. Looks like right at 260. Extend that line. 260. Okay, so where it intersects, we will make a line from where we thought he was to where we think he is now. Gives us a course of about 55 degrees. We can extend that 55 degree course like that. So we're actually, like, if our estimation here is correct, we're in a pretty good position to intercept. We're about 6 kilometers away from where we think he'll be. And I'm just going to take another listen. Yeah, it sounds like he's moving. That's on the fast end of slow. Let's just see what the conditions are like out here. Hoping it's not still storming. Oh, I think it is, which means we're not going to have any visual contact at all until we're about 500 meters away. Yeah, so I guess this will be a good example of how you can hunt like solely off sound, but it's really not an appealing way to hunt. Very tedious and not very exciting because you can't really see what's going on. Sounds like it's a big enough target though, so maybe we'll pursue this. So we'll just set a course for about 90 degrees, perpendicular to where we think his course is. I'll show you how we're going to do that here. Just take the protractor. So we think his course is 55 degrees. You can just estimate that and be like, okay, I know I've got to make, what would it be, like 45 degrees plus 90, so 135, and then another 10 because it's 55. Like we should probably set our course for like 145. So obviously you don't need to use these tools every time. I'm pretty sure it's 145, but this is just kind of how I do it. I like to use the tool so I'm not hurting myself with mental math here. I don't want to think too hard, but 325. Oh, I'm thinking of the inverse. Yeah, so we've got 145 if we're looking the other way, but we want to set course for 325. My mistake. 325.
Jawohl, Herr Kaloin. Neuer Kurs, 3, 2, 4.
So since we're to the right of where this guy's going, we actually subtracted 90 degrees from his course. So 55 minus 90, that's going to give us that 325 course. So we will be to starboard of where he's looking. If you think he's heading in this direction, angle on bow is basically what angle he has to look to see us. So we want that to be 90. We want to always be intercepting at a 90 degree angle on bow, perpendicular to the course. That's why we set our course the way we did. And when we're setting it up in the TDC, this angle on bow thing here, since we're on the right of his course, we are to starboard of his ship, we're going to be setting this to 90 degrees starboard. If we were going 145, like I was saying before, like if we were heading kind of southeast and our course was 145, we were coming from this side of the line, then our angle on bow would be 90 degrees to port. So we'd set that arrow over there. Now, when you're setting this up, what you need to do is on your periscope, it has to be lined up at zero. So what that's telling the TDC is when you're looking at zero, straight ahead of the sub, that means if the target was at zero, if the target was exactly where we're looking, his angle on bow would be 90 degrees, okay? So if we make a line straight ahead of us like that, okay? So that's straight ahead. So if the ship is in that line, go like this. That means that roughly it's a 90 degree angle on bow to starboard the target. Now, when you keep this little tick to the left, that's going to update every time we change the direction of our periscope. So if I set the speed to say 7 knots, I'm guessing he's going 7 knots. and then I put manual input off. Now that angle tracking is active, so you'll notice the gyro angle here is saying about 10 degrees. So that means if we're looking at 0 degrees, so straight ahead of the sub, the torpedo is actually going to fire toward 10 degrees, because by the time the torpedo gets to the ship will have moved to the 10-degree mark right there. So, you know, as I turn left to right, the gyro angle is turning. And you want the torpedo to hit as close to zero as possible. So if I fire when I have to look at 350 degrees to see him, you'll see the gyro angle is now at 358. So that's pretty close to zero. So when I'm looking here and I fire at 350, the torpedo is actually going to fire in a straight line right here at about 358. And by the time the target gets there, that's pretty much where the torpedo is going to hit. So if that's all Greek to you, don't worry about it. I'll show you kind of how this looks. It's going to be not ideal in a storm, but you can just see that that's typically how it goes. If a ship's going slow, it's about 10 degrees. If a ship's going fast, it's closer to 15, 20. So if he was going like 12, 14 knots, and I was looking at 340, well, then our gyro angle would be closer to zero. But basically, what you need to know about the TDC is that if you set up the 90 degree angle when you're lined up perfectly at zero and you've got their speed estimated, then it's always going to update when you turn. That you should be checking with your periscope, looking left to right, because if you keep the manual input on, I'll just show you. If you keep the manual input on like this and you look left to right, you'll notice the gyro angle does not change. So the trick of this whole thing is to set up for 90 degrees, turn input off, and now every time you look left to right, the TDC will update the torpedo solution for you. So now I'm looking at 340, the angle on bow is going to be, the angle on bow is now 70 degrees. So if I'm looking at 340, again, this line is at 340, like that. See, it's now a 70 degree angle on bow. And that's basically, the computer is just doing that work for you. So we don't want to have to manually punch that in every time we look left to right. But that's kind of what's going on. Okay, so I've been having our sonar man track relative position of this merchant. You'll notice it's been going down here. If I scroll up, it's gone from 297 down to, well, close to 290. So that means if we keep going the way we're going, we're actually going to cross his path before he gets to us. But we'll just keep the periscope up so that it takes us out of time compression if we do see anything. And we'll be keeping an eye on where he is. So I'll just play a little with the time compression here. We want to keep that not going too low, not going too high. So, okay, it's really starting to speed up now, which means we're either getting close to us, or close to him, or he's starting to get out of reach. So let's take a listen. Sounds very close. Should almost be able to see him here at 305-ish. So he should be coming into view really soon. Just gonna give it a little longer. Maybe speed us up. Oh, okay. Where is he? There he is. Okay, just a tramp steamer, it looks like. So you can quiet down, Sonarman. I'm gonna stop us here. We're just gonna ID this guy really quick. So unfortunately we had to do that all by hydrophones, and I think we were pretty lucky to actually catch this guy in this storm. But we'll do the rest visually here. So I guess our estimate of his course was pretty accurate. Like, obviously it's gotta be a little bit further this way, but we'll just get a point of where he is here. Tramp steamer. So usually you can get all this done at much greater distances, but this is what we got. So that is the tramp steamer right there. We're gonna check this box. Now let's just get, if I had active sonar, we could get his range a lot easier, but we're just gonna fight with the bobbing periscope here. Set this to lock. And top of the mast. I mean, that's not very accurate, but it's saying, well, he's probably 600 to 650 meters away at about 316 relative bearing. So I can put that in on the map. 650 at 316. Ooh, that's going to be rough. I mean, he's something like right there. So yeah, our course estimate was probably pretty accurate. I'm just going to move this line over to connect the dots. So yeah, his course is probably about 55 degrees. I'm going to throw us into reverse, just because we're going to be within safety range of this guy. You do want to be stationary when doing a speed check of these guys, or you can just be moving slowly, but wait till he's pretty close to, you know, 350, 0, 10 degrees, just so our speed doesn't interfere with the measurement. But yeah, I'm going to back us up just so our torpedo actually has room to hit. Also, okay, just wanted to make sure it was British. He is, in fact, British. Now, I think we'll just fire one torpedo. It's really not even worth one. It's not even 2,000 tons. Draft is 6.8 meters, so I'm actually going to set the depth of this torpedo to about just under 3 meters, just because with all the bobbing and the storm, we don't want it to go right under him or dead out on the bottom of the ship. So we've got the speed setting set to fast, impact pistol, and depth of just under 3 meters. But really the biggest thing here is, like, since our course was basically correct, we've already got the TDC set up so that 0 degrees is 90. If we go like this, we can see that 0 degrees, well, it gives us 87. It's pretty close. We can update that, but that's nitpicking. It's not really going to matter. Change it to about 87. And speed, you know, if we're plus or minus a knot, it shouldn't matter at this range. Range info is only useful for finding out how long the torpedo is going to take to get there, but this is going to be a very close shot. Okay, so what we're going to do now is figure out how fast he's going. So I'm going to start the stopwatch now as he comes into the line. And what we're going to do is take a calculator, take the length of the ship, so 78.5 meters, multiply it by 1.94, and divide it by whatever time it takes for him to cross that line. So we should be stationary for this, but whatever. Stop. It's at 23 seconds. Okay, 78.5 multiplied by 1.94, then divided by 23 seconds. That gives us 6.5 knots. So it's probably a little bit off since we're not stationary. So I'm just going to keep it at 7 knots. We're going to open tube 2, do another range check. This is not going to be accurate, but he's going to be about 600 meters away. Should be about 22 seconds to impact, so we're gonna fire. And the gyro angle's 33, so this is not optimal. We were kind of forced to rush that, and we didn't get our complete information until he was already past zero. So, like, the angle of impact is gonna be not perpendicular, but that should hit. And it was a little further away than we thought, but good hit. For a second there, I thought we had a dud. Guess I could have checked if he's armed. I probably shouldn't be sitting here with my periscope up if he's gonna spot us. I think he is unarmed, though. Yeah, and I'm hoping that'll send him down. Don't really want to waste any more on this.
Jawohl, Herr Kaloin. Große Fahrt voraus.
Didn't see us, okay. And you can watch the fireworks when he blows up or whatever, I like to just get down to, usually I wouldn't be keeping my periscope up like this, I'd just be listening on the hydrophones, but there's not a lot of danger here. We'll keep track of them and listen at about 20 meters, get that torpedo reloaded. Alright, 1726, and we've got confirmation that she's going down. That was about 5 minutes after impact. And yeah, it was a tramp steamer for 1964 tons. I mean, for a single torpedo, I guess that's not too bad. I wish I would have got an opportunity to show you what this is like in clear conditions when you're actually plotting it out on a map, like doing range checks periodically, but I guess that's a good example of how you can track a target just by hydrophones. Wasn't very clean, but there you go.